Hello guys, and welcome back to the third episode of Steelers Road to Redemption. In the last episode, we got up to 62 thieving, which is one of the requirements to unlock safecracking. We also touched Herb Law and got that up to 7. We then picked up the Supreme Jack of Trades aura, and I am now going to kill the trolls to try and get a charge bow up from there, as the bow has infinite arrows, which makes it really nice for Jack of Trades runs, since you can just take out the bow from the bank and you don't have to worry about arrows. Another nice bonus from killing the trolls here is that they commonly drop Grimy Grams and Gold Charms here. This of course means that we can craft a few more attack potions, so that we can get a higher base level for when we turn in our Jack of Trades books. This will result in more experience of course, so that is pretty good. So I just looked on the wiki, and they apparently removed the charge bow as it dropped from the trolls here. I do however have another solution in mind, and we are now going to do the Blood Pact quest to get another free arrowless bow from there. That literally took 2 minutes, and we now have the charge bow for our Jack of Trades runs. Finally, for our Jack of Trades runs, we want to unlock summoning, so let us do the Wolf Whistle quest now. There we have it, the Wolf Whistle is now completed. I actually don't know if you still need to do this quest to actually unlock summoning, but it literally took us 5 minutes, so that didn't take long at all. Now I will do a run of Jack of Trades, and I will see you guys when I get the book. Okay, so let's talk to Xuan here to get our first reward book on the account. Before we redeem the book, I am going to look on the wiki to see if there are some easy quests that we can do to bump up our Herb Lore level so that the book gives us more experience. I just had a quick look on the wiki, and if you are new to Iron Man mode, you can actually search for quest experience rewards on the RuneScape wiki, and it will give you a list of all the skills and show you which quests give you experience in the skill. Looking at it, it seems like I can only do Jungle Potion and Recruitment Drive at my current Herb Lore level. Recruitment Drive isn't really an option since you need to kill a level 30 NPC without any gear, meaning you basically have to punch him to death. And I don't think that is a viable solution with our low melee stats, so I'm just going to stick with the jungle quest for now. We are just handing in the last herb here to complete the quest. There we go. Redeeming the lamp here should take us up to 11 herb lore. And when we killed the trolls, we collected a few grams, 47 to be precise. And we might as well turn those into attack potions for a bit more experience. That will be the last of our potions made for now. That leaves us at 16 herb lore, and we are now going to pop the book here and see where that takes us. Oh, it looks like it is only 830 experience. But then again, we also are really low level, so yeah. Anyways, that takes us up to 18 herb lore. So with the Premier Club artifact, you can actually get a free aura reset every day. So we will use that on Herb Lore for a long while, since it is really easy free experience in that skill. So let us activate the aura again, and I'll see you guys when I get my second book. There we have it, let's use our second book on Herb Lore. Nice, that takes us up to 20 Herb Lore. I don't think I mentioned it, but right now I am pushing to get 30 Herb Lore. There are a few quests that gives us 20,000 Herb Lore experience as lamps. However, to redeem the lamps, we need a base level of 30 Herb Lore to actually activate them. And that is why I'm pushing to get 30 Herb Lore as soon as possible. I am now going to do the Stronghold of Player Safety, as that gives us a lamp that gives 1000 experience in a skill of our choice. There we go, that should give us the lamps. Let us go and put our lamps here into Herb Lore experience. Nice, so that takes us up to 21 Herb Lore, one step closer to 30. Oh, I didn't know, but apparently we also get 10,000 GP. That's pretty nice and will definitely be useful in the future. I am now going to do the Dig Site quest, as it gives us a bit of Herb Lore experience and a lot of mining experience. As you guys can see here, it also doesn't have a required mining level, so it is a really easy way to skip past the early mining levels, which tend to be a bit slow. To do the quest, we need 10 agility, so I am now going to go over to the Burfo agility course and I will knock out that requirement real quick. So, that took like 5 minutes and we are now 10 agility. Let us go and do the deck side quest now, as we should have all of the requirements. Alternatively, I could just have done the tourist trap, as that quest would take us up to 27 agility. But this was super fast anyways, and I didn't want to branch too far out from our goal. Hey guys, this is Stilo from the future. So, they apparently reworked the entire deck side area, so it was a bit hard finding everything. If you guys are following along my route, I just thought that I would mention that you can actually pick up all the things that you need to make the explosive potion right here. This is just north of the rocks, so it makes it really easy. There we have it. That should be the deck side done. So that takes us up to 24 blow, and Jesus, that's a lot. That actually takes us up to 31 mining as well. Man, that is a lot of levels that we can now skip, so that is really nice. That literally gave us 29 mining levels, and I am actually pretty shocked. Since we now only need 6 more Urblor levels, I think I might as well go to the resource dungeon in the wilderness that has all of the cast raids in it, and just grind those until I have enough herbs to hit 30 Urblor. F**k, I need 10 engineering to enter the dungeon apparently. I completely forgot about that. Oh man, that is f**king annoying. Oh well, I am going to see if I can get one of my friends to let me leech an Elite Dungeon 1 miniboss, as they give 5000 engineering tokens, and that way I don't have to do all the annoying early engineering levels, since you can use the tokens to buy experience. Okay, so I found a friend of mine who is willing to let me leech a miniboss, so let us make a group and teleport there. For f**k's sake. Ugh, I need impressing the locals to actually do the elite dungeons. This is really not going to plan. Oh well, I guess I will finish that and then hopefully we should be able to finally get started. Great, and I don't even have the Pod's Rim lodestone unlocked. What a f**king day this has been. Oh yeah, and since we didn't unlock the Pod's Rim lodestone, we might as well just do it while we are here. Okay, so that should be impressing the locals done. Hopefully now we can teleport to the elite dungeons. Perfect, so we can actually teleport there now, and I will see you guys when I'm killing the mini bosses.
Bruh, look at this. Wait till you see the no.
Well, that was just fucking insane. Did you guys see that? Oh well, I think I will also add a death counter from now on, so that we can keep track of how many deaths I had. Yeah, that was really annoying. I basically disconnected really hard and then it surged into everything. If you guys could see that, I basically was clicking the ground, but it didn't react at all, so the surge got really delayed. Oh well. We made our way back to the elite dungeon, so let's kill the mini bosses here. Perfect, that gives us 5000 experience, and my friend here apparently wants to kill the other miniboss as well, so let us do that. So I just want to say a huge thank you to my friend right here.
I appreciate you.
DIY Solo RS, he is a really nice guy that I used to know back when I played on my old Iron Man. But yeah, a huge thank you goes to you for actually boosting me here in the Elite Dungeon. But yeah, guys, that is going to be it for this episode. But before you go, please feel free to follow me on my Twitch channel over on twitch.tv/watchstilo. If you follow me there, then you'll get a notification when I go live. Other than that, I also made a Discord that you guys can join if you guys want to come and chat with me. And if that isn't your cup of tea, then I'm also in my French chat. Finally, these videos take a huge amount of time to edit, so a like would be amazing. And if you guys haven't already, then be sure to subscribe to my channel for more Iron Man content in the future. But that is going to be it for me, guys. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye bye.